Hello everyone, welcome to Grade Up. Okay, today we are going to discuss the Quant and DI section of ZAT 2020. Okay, so let's start with the questions. Okay, one of the easy questions. So there were very few easy questions, direct questions. But yes, this was one of them. So very, very easy. You can do it directly. So five, the symbol meaning of this symbol is given that you need to add and then multiply by the second value. So five, this circle two means 5 plus 2. So it will be 5 plus 2, 7 into 2. So this will become 14. Then 14.5. So 14 plus 5 into 5. So this will be 95. So simple. So very, very easy questions. Right? So first option is 95. Correct option is option 1, 95. Okay. Let's move to next one. Okay. So here the question was, two friends Ram and Shyam start at the same point at the same time. Ram travels straight north. Okay, let's draw this. So from here they both started. Ram started in northward. So this is, let's say, north. So this must be east. At 10 km per hour. So Ram is traveling at, so Ram is traveling at 10 km per hour. And while Shyam travels straight east at twice the speed of Ram, so here Shyam is traveling at 20 km per hour. Now after 15 minutes, Shyam messages Ram that he is passing by a large telephone tower. So in 15 minutes, Shyam is passing through a telephone tower. So 15 minutes. 20 kilometer he can travel in 1 hour, 60 minutes. So 15 minutes is 1/4. So 1/4, that means 5 kilometers. So in 15 minutes, it will cover 5 kilometers. So here the telephone tower is there. Right? Okay, and after another 15 minutes, now total of 30 minutes, Ram messaged Shyam that he is passing by an old banyan tree. Okay, so total 30 minutes, Ram will also travel 5 because in 1 hour he can travel 10 kilometers. So in 30 minutes, he will travel 5, so at 5 kilometers. Here is that banyan tree. Okay, so here also 5 kilometers, here also 5 kilometers. Shyam, okay, after some more time has elapsed, Ram and Shyam stops. They stop at the same point of time if the straight line distance between Ram and Shyam now is 50. Okay, so see, Ram is covering X, Shyam is covering 2X because they traveled for the same time and the distance straight line between is 50. If this is 50, and this is x, this is 2x. So the question is, how far is Shyam from the banyan tree? So Shyam is here. Here it is Ram. This is the starting point. Right? And here the banyan tree is there, which is at a distance of 5 km. So first you need to calculate x. Right? So we can calculate that because x square plus 2x square, that is 4x square plus 5x. 5x square equal to 2500. Pythagoras. So x is 10 root 5. So x is 10 root 5. So that means this is 20 root 5. If this is 20 root 5 and this is 5, I want to have this distance BS. So 20 square 400 into 5, 2000 plus 25. So 2025 square root. So this will be 2025 square root, which is 45. Right? Okay, so story was lengthy. The values are okay, somewhat on the easier side, because this, even if you are getting this root something, but 2025 is a perfect square, so you are getting this as an integer. 45 square, we know 2025, so we can easily do this, right? Okay, question was average level or above average level difficulty, because the story was lengthy. So you need to understand, you need to read the story, understand the story, and do it exactly what is required. Okay, so let's move to next question. Okay, next question is, Nalini has received a total of 600 WhatsApp messages from 4 friends A, B, C, D. Okay, let's say A, B, C, D. So Nalini is receiving the messages. B and D have respectively sent 30% and 20% of these messages. So B and D. So 30%, let's say 30x and 20x. Let's say the total messages are 100x. While A has sent an equal number of messages as C, and A and C equal, so 50x already gone, so 50x, so 25x. Right? So 100x messages are the total messages, while Anita has sent equal. Okay. Moreover, Nalini finds that of A, B and C and D's, 60-40, this are jokes. Okay, what percent of the jokes received by this have been sent neither by? Okay, so easy. So that means 60% of this is jokes, 60% is, that means 15x, these are jokes. Okay, 60% is 3 by 5. 40% of B's, 40% is 12x. 80% of this is 20x. And 50% is 10x. Now the question is, what percent of jokes, so these are the jokes, how much? 30 and 40 57. So out of 57x have been sent neither by D nor by B. So D and B, remove that, so that means 35. Okay, so this is my answer. So you can divide directly to get the answer. Okay, this would be close to 60%. So these two cannot be your answer, right? Okay, so I will divide it. 57 into 6. 57 into 6 is 342. Yes, so it is more than 60. So this also gone. So 57 into 6 is 342. So 80. So it will be 57 into 1, right? So this can be only possibility, this cannot be your answer, right? So again, a simple question, but written in that complicated manner, written in a long story. So again, even if you do this question, it will consume some part of time. Okay, so let's move to next question. So, but it is on the easier side. Okay, next one is, a man is laying stones from start to end along the two sides of a 200 meter walkway. So 200 meter, the stones are to be laid 5 meter apart from each other. So 5 meter apart from each other, like this. So there will be like this. When he begins, all the stones are present at the start of the walkway. So all stones are present here, let's say. Okay. He placed the first stone on each side of the walkway start. So here he placed the stone. For all the other stones, the man lays the stones first along one of the walkway sides, then along the other side in an exactly similar fashion. Oh, I'm sorry. However, he can carry only one stone at a time. So to lay each stone, the man walks to the spot, lays the stone, and then walks back to pick the other. Okay, so what he will do? So he will pick one stone, he will put it here and come back. So 5 plus 5, he will travel 10 meter. But the next, he will pick from stone from here. Then he will go to here, come back. So he will now travel 10 and 10, 20. So next stone, 15 and 15, 30. So, like this, he will travel the distance for each stone. Right? Okay. Now, after laying all the stone, the man walks back to the start. So, that means for the last stone also, he will travel and come back. So, 200 meter plus 200 meter. So, 400 meter he will travel. So, 10, 20, 30 up to 400. Right? Okay. What is the total distance? Assume that width of the walkway is negligible. So, that means you need to add this from 10 to 400 twice. Because he need to lay stone on the both the side of the walkway. Right? And the width is negligible, so the same point again he need to travel. So first he will lay stone on one side and then on the other side, right? But the same distance. So that means 10 plus 20, so this is an AP. If you want to add this first term plus last term by 2 into number of terms are 40 into 2, because you need to add it twice, right? 2 cancelled. So, 410 into 40, 41 into 4, 164. So, this is your answer, 16400, right? 16200 is also mentioned. Suppose he is to put the last stone and then the story is over. But it is also given that after laying all the stones, the man walks back to the start. So, he need to come back to the start. So, that also need to be considered. So, it should be 16400, not 16200. Right? Okay? So, let's move to next question. A rectangular swimming pool is 500 meter long and 25 meter wide. Okay? So, its depth is... Okay, depth is also there. So, something like... let's say 50 meter long, 25 meter width, but there is width along its length from 1 meter to 4 meter. So, here the width is 1 meter, here the width is 4 meter. So, it's something like this. The width is varying like this, right? So, this is a kind of, okay. If you consider this figure, just see this. This is a trapezium. And then there is width of the pool. So, this trapezium will become trapezoid, right? Three dimensional. So, this is what the volume you need to calculate. That means the volume you need to calculate. The volume, simple, volume of a trapezoid, that means volume of the trapezium plus height is now width. So I am taking this as a base and this is a height, right? Okay, instead of taking this as a height, I am taking this as a base and that is a height, right? Okay, so trapezium, area of trapezium is average of parallel side into height. So, this is the area of trapezium into that height into 25. So, 26, 25 into 5, 3125. So, this is your cubic meters volume. So, 3125 is your volume. So, simple question. If you understand the figure, then it was very, very simple. So, very easy question. Okay, 3125 is your answer. Okay, let's move to next one. Two lighthouses located at point A and B on the earth, okay, A, B, are 60 feet and 40 feet. So, 60 feet, 40 feet, two lighthouses. Each lighthouse is perfectly vertical, and the land connected A and B is perfectly flat. The topmost point of the lighthouse A is A dash. And the lighthouse B is B dash. Draw line segment A dash B and B dash A. Let them intersect at point C dash. Drop a perpendicular C dash to touch the earth at point C. Right? So, what is the length of C dash in feet? So, this was very easy. If you know the formula, this is half of harmonic mean. right? If this is a, this is x, this is y, then this is xy plus xy over x plus y, half of harmonic mean, right? I will tell you why. So xy is 16 to 40. So if you know this, this was the, this easy. Directly see 100, both 0 gone, 24 is the answer, right? Why half of harmonic mean? You know, okay, if I join this line also, okay, let's say I join this line, then if I extend this, so this becomes actually trapezium, and this is the line passing through the intersection of the diagonals and parallel to the parallel sides. This line is your harmonic mean, 2xy over x plus y, harmonic mean, and wherever it, the diagonals intersect, the both ways, it will be equal. CC dash will be equal to C dash something. So this part will be equal to this part. So half of harmonic mean here, half of harmonic mean here. Right? So you can, you must be knowing this formula. Right? Half of harmonic mean or full harmonic mean there. Right? We can solve this also, but no need to do this. Right? This is directly xy over x plus y. Now, XYZ started a web-based venture together. So, X invest rupees 2.5 lakhs. So, partnership type of thing. X invested 2.5 lakhs. Y invested 3.5 lakhs. And Z invested 4 lakhs. In the first year, the venture makes a profit of 2 lakhs. A part of the profit is shared between Y and Z in the ratio 2 is to 3. Okay, so some part, so let's say 2x and 3x is given to these two, and the remaining profit is divided among x, y and z in the ratio of their initial investment. So ratio of initial investment is 5 is to 7 is to 8. Okay, so let's say they will get 5m plus 7m, 8m. The amount that Z received is 4 times. Z received is, that means 3x plus 8m is 4 times the amount that X receives, that is 5m. So 20 minus 8, 12m is equal to 3x. That means X equal to 4m. So, you can put x equal to 4m. So, 3x equal to 12m. So, this will be 12m. And this will be 4. So, 8m. Right? How much amount does y receive? Now, see. The total amount received by these are, x will receive 5m. Okay. 5. Y will receive 8 plus 7, 15m. And z will receive 12 plus 8, 20m. So, the ratio, you can see 1 is to 3 is to 4. That means Y will receive 3 parts out of 1, 3, 4 and 4, 8. And total profit was given. The venture makes a profit of 2 lakhs. So, 2 lakhs. So, 8 into 25. 25 into 3, 75. So, 75 would be your correct answer. Right? Normal partnership question. Right? Only thing is, this is the ratio given plus this also given, that they, Y and Z, let's say they were working partner, they will get some extra. Right? Okay. So, let's move to next one. When expressed in a decimal form, which of the following number will be non-terminating as well as non-repeating? Okay. Non-terminating, non-repeating. Okay, you know, irrational numbers. Okay, just see. Pi by 2. Pi is an irrational. So, pi in expression, just see this. If you multiply this, pi by 2, then bracket 1 by pi. So, this will become pi cancelled. 1 by 2 plus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2. So this cancels. So this is not at non-terminal. This is a rational number, 1 by 2. Okay. So here it is infinite term. So I will check it later. Right? Infinite term. So I know that this is a GP. Right? And that too, because 1 plus pi by 4, pi by 4 square, pi by 4 is less than 1. So diminishing GP, infinite terms, you know the sum is a over 1 minus r. Right? You can do this. Right? Let's say 4 minus pi. In exam, I won't have done this before. So I will check other first. Right? Easier one first. Okay? So this is, and 1, this is a over 1 minus r. So r is pi by 4 only. So this will become 4 minus pi and 4 will be there. So 4 will come here. And this will become 4 minus pi. 4 minus pi will cancel. So there is no pi in this. So this is also rational. Right? So here root 2 into this will become rational number. Right? Minus root 2 cancel out. Plus root 3. Oh, this root 3 cannot be cancelled out. So this is the irrational number. This is a non-terminating, non-repeating number. So this option is your non-terminating and non-repeating number. Right? Rest all. You can see 22 by 7 is not irrational. It is a rational number. That means even if it is non-terminating, it will be repeating. Right? Okay. And root, cube root of 729 is 9. Okay. Then these value you can think of. Right? Okay. So let's move to next one. Okay. Next question. X, Y and Z are three software experts who work for an upgrading on upgrading the software into a number of identical systems. X takes a day off after every 3 days of work. Y takes a day off after every 4 days. And Z takes a day off after 5 days. So X is working like this. So 3 days. Okay, 3 days X will work and then it won't work. Then 3 days X will work, then it won't work. So Y is working like Y will work for 4 days and then it won't work. Something like this. So similarly, Z will be taking after 5 days off day. So starting afresh after a common day off. So it is also given like this. Starting after a common day off, X and Y working together can complete one new upgrade job in 6 days. Right? Okay. X is working for 3 days and then taking one day off. So in 6 days, he will work like work, 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 not work. Work, work. So 6 days completed. So X, after 3 days, X will take off. So after in 6 days, Y will work, 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 not work, work. So Y will also work for 5 days. So effectively in this, X and Y will work for 5 days, right? So in first case, 5 X days and 5 Y days are required to complete one job. So this is the definition of one upgrade job, right? Okay, so second is that Z and X working together can complete two new upgrade jobs in eight days. Now, Z will work, 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 and then not work. So 6 days, 7, 8. And X will work now for 3 days and then not work. 3 days and then not work. So that means in this second scenario, Z will work for out of 8, 7 days, but X will work for 6 days. And this is twice the job. If this is one job, this is twice job. Right? One unit, anything. This is twice unit. Right? Okay, we will equate that. Let's see. Now, see here. Y and Z working together can complete three new upgrade jobs. Right? in 12 days. So why? Because Y is taking after 4 days rest. So 4 days, 1 rest. 4 days, 1 rest. So 5, 5, 10 days and 2. So that means there will be 2 rest days. So Y will work for 10 days. And Z will also 5 plus 1, 5 plus 1 rest, then 5 plus 1 rest. So again 10 days. So it will be 3 units of job. Right. So now this means okay, one unit of job is this. So from here, if we can conclude something, okay, let's see. From here, x plus y. Okay, this is triple of that. So 15x plus 15y is equal to 10y plus 10z. This is 3 times. So I have multiplied 3 times and equated this. So 15 minus 10, okay, you can divide it by 5 entirely. So it will become 3, 3, 2, 2. So 3 minus 2, y equal to 2z minus 3x or 3x plus y equal to 2z. Right? Okay, let it be like this. Second is, if I put the value of z here, right? Okay, if I put the value of z here, so it will become, okay, let's equate this also, because double of this is equal to this, so this will become 10x, so let's write it here, change the color, so 10x plus 10y will be equal to 7z plus 6x. So 10 minus 6, 4x plus 10y equal to 7z. Now you know z value of z you can equate. Right? Okay, value of z let's equate. So z here is 4x plus 10y. By 7, here it is 3x plus 2y, 3x plus y by 2. So this will become 8x plus 20y equal to 21x plus 7y. So 13x is equal to 13y. That means x equal to y. So, x and y are equal, right? So, if x equal to y, then put the values. So, x equal to y and here, so let's say here or here. Now, x equal to y, that means you can put y equal to x. So this is equal to 4x equal to 2z. So z equal to 2x. Right? Now just think of the numbers. Let's say x, y and z. Right? They are working. Because z is twice of x and x and y are equal. Let's say x will do 1 unit, y will do 1 unit, z will do double. Right? And the total work is 1 unit, 1 new upgrade job is 5x plus 5y, which is 5, x is 1 unit and y is 1 unit, so 10 unit. So total job is 10 unit. And now they all are together working. So 10 by 4. So that means they will take 2.5 days. And within 2.5 days, nobody will take any break. So 2.5 days should be your correct answer. Right? So 2.5 days must be your correct answer. right? Okay, let's move to next one. Consider the four variables A, B, C and D and the function Z of these variables. Okay, this was looking that monster type. Okay, difficult one. But just see that it was given that A, B, C, D must be non-negative integers. And the conditions, just look at the conditions. If they are non-negative integers, right, that means they can be 0, 1, something. Just see the first one. And the condition is, the question is, if Z needs to maximize. Now, I need to maximize this. If I need to maximize this, B must be minimum because it is a negative. So, if 2A plus B is less than or equal to 2, I will put B as 0 because A can be 1 here. Right? Otherwise, this condition will not satisfy. Okay? Otherwise, you can take B2 and A0. Why should you take A0? Because I need to maximize this and this is a 15 into A square. So, I don't want to make A0 and B2. So, this will be negative will be more, positive will be less. So, I don't want to do this. So, simply B will be 0, A will be 1. If B is 0, right? If B is 0, so this part is 0. A is 1, so this is 4. So, 4 plus C is less than or equal to 12. So, C may be 8 also. Right? C may be 8, but C is not required. My thing is, then what value can D take? Right? Now, that means, here B is 0 definite, A is 1, so 3 plus this is 0, so 3 plus D must be less than equal to 15. Now D I want to maximize, what can be the what value must D take, right? Okay, so 3A plus 4B plus D must be less than equal to 15. Okay, yes, I want to maximize D. If I want to maximize D, this is written as D, this has to maximize. So, D must be maximum. Because if I take D a low value, so this won't be added. If I can take here 3 plus 1 also, 3 plus 0 also, right? But then this value will be less. If I take D as 12, 3 plus 12, 15, 12 maximum. So, this value will increase, right? The value of Z will increase. So, maximum I can take D as 12, right? For Z also to be maximized. So, D will be 12, right? So, this was a simple question because A and B were fixed, almost fixed in the first condition, right? Because if you take A as 0 and B as 2, only two possible cases, A1, B0 or A0, B2, right? If you take A0, B2, then this Z won't be maximized, right? The value will be in negative then. Okay, let's move to next one. Now, XYZ is an equilateral triangle inscribed in a circle. So, a circle, a equilateral triangle. So, X, Y, Z. P is a point on the arc YZ such that X and P are on opposite side. So, P is here somewhere on this arc. Right? So, P can be anywhere. Which of the following must be true? XP equal to XY? XP equal to XY? No. No, no. Not possible, right? This must be true, must always be true, right? This is not possible, XP and XY, because here the center is here. From here it is like this, it is equal. From here it cannot be equal. This is not the center of this circle, right? Okay, now XZ plus YP equal to XY plus. Now, XZ and XY are equal. These are equilateral triangle. So, this is equal. So, that means YP equal to PZ. YP equal to PZ. That means P must be in the center. This is not given. So, this is not true. Right? XP equal to XY plus YZ. XP equal to XY plus YZ. Oh, not possible. XY plus YZ, two sides equal to this. No, not possible. Right? You cannot even visualize this. Right? This is two lengths. XY plus YZ, two lengths. That is not the distance. Right? Okay? That cannot be. Now, XP plus PZ. XP plus PZ equal to XY. XY plus YP. Okay, I told you earlier also that this is anywhere possible. So, let's say P is suppose in the center, then XP is not equal to XY, but YP will be equal to PZ. That means this will become equal, but this is not equal. So, this is not possible in that case, right? Even if this is not true in one case, because this always must always be true. So, the only thing remaining is XP equal to YP plus YZ. PZ, that must be true, right? Okay, XP is this equal to YP plus PZ. Okay, the thing is this. Let's say I don't know whether this will be true or not, right? Because P can be anywhere. If P can be anywhere, P can be at this point also. Let's take P on Y. If P is on Y, YP will become 0. But then PZ will become one length. That is YZ. This will become YZ. And XP, because P is here, it will become XY. And XY equal to YZ, yes, because these are the sides of equilateral triangle. Right? If I have taken P here, let's say I have taken P at center. If P is at the center, it will pass through the center. That means it will be 2R. Right? 2R. And if P is here, okay, just think of this. Just draw this also. This is 120 because that is 60. Cyclic. And this is also 120 because in center. Right? You can just see this. So, this is 30, this is 30, this is 30, this is 30. So, these are congruent triangle. If these are congruent triangle, so this is R, this is R, this is R, this is R. So, this is 2R. So, YP plus PZ will be 2R if it P is at the center and XP will be 2R because this is the diameter. So, in case it is at the center, this is true. In case P is here, it is true. So, why should I prove it for others? Otherwise also, other four options were gone, negative, right, rejected. So, that means the option should be 5 only. Okay. Let's move to next one. Ashok has a bag containing 40 cards numbered with the integer 1 to 40. Okay. So, Ashok numbered 1 to 40. No two cards are numbered with the same integers. Likewise, his sister Shilpa has another bag containing only 5 cards are numbered from integer 1 to 5. Shilpa 1 to 5, again, no integer repeating. Their mother Lata randomly draws one card each from Ashok and Shilpa's bag and notes down their respective numbers. So, one from here and one from here. Right? One card. Whatever the numerical value is. Right? N and M. Okay, now if Lata divides the number obtained from Ashok's bag by the number obtained from Shilpa's bag, so this divided by this, what is the probability that the remainder will not be greater than 2? Not be greater than 2, right? That means the remainder must be either 0 or 1 or 2, not greater than 2, right? So, whenever you are dividing from 1 to 5, the maximum remainder are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, either I can see that my probability is this. Favorable cases are these remainders. right? So either I can count this, these will be more in numbers, or I can count 3 and 4 and then subtract that from the total probability, that is 1. I can get the probability of getting 3 and 4 as a remainder and then subtract from 1, right? So when I will get 3 as a remainder, when I will divide this by 4, because till 3, 1, 2, 3, I cannot get 3 as a remainder. Dividing by 1, dividing by 2 or dividing by 3, I cannot get 3 as a remainder. When I am dividing by 4, dividing by 4, okay, so dividing by 4 or dividing by 5. Here I will say how many cases? If I am dividing by 4 and there are 40 numbers, the remainder possible are 0, 1, 2, 3. If you are dividing by 4, the remainder possible are 0, 1, 2, 3. And there are 40 numbers, so they will, all 4 remainder will appear 10 times. So 3 remainder will also appear 10 times. So 10 favorable cases will be there. When I am dividing by 4, 0, 1, 2 are the not required here. I am talking about 3 now. I am just considering 3 as a remainder. So 3 as a remainder will be 1/4 of the numbers. Right? Because first numbers 1 will give me remainder 1, 2 will give me remainder 2, 3 will give me remainder 3, 4 will give me remainder 0. Then again 5 will give me remainder 1, 6 will give me remainder 2, 7 remainder 3, 8 will remainder 0. So 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0. So all remainder 0, 1, 2, 3 will have same number of occurrences. So out of 40, 10 will be remainder 3. Right? So divisibility by 5, I can get 3 and 4 both. But total remainder possible are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 possibilities. Out of these, 2 are favorable. And all 5, because there are 40 numbers, 5 into 8, all 5 will occur 8 times. So those 2 favorable will occur 2 into 8, 16 times. So 16 favorable cases here. So for these, I have 26 cases favorable out of 40 into 5, 200 cases. So this is the probability of getting 3 and 4. Now probability of getting 0, 1 and 2 is 1 minus this, which is 13 by 100. 1 minus 0.313 is 0.87. 0.87 is my correct answer. Right? You can calculate for 0, 1, 2 directly. But because 3 and 4, the cases will be less, so I calculated for that and subtracted from 1, total probability of getting this or not getting this, the total must be 1, right? So 1 minus 0.13, 0.87 would be your correct answer, right? Okay, let's move to next one. Okay, this is the next question. So DI set. The following graphs depict sector-wise percentage contribution to the gross domestic product GDP of 9 nations. Okay, so nations label A, B and so on. And actual nations are Brazil, China, France, Germany, India, Japan. So not necessarily in the same order. That means one task is that you need to identify which one is which. So A is Brazil or China or France. So you need to identify that also, right? And these are three different sectors. GDP is given in the data. Okay. So additional information was also given. Okay. Here the following, however, are known GDPs of the 9 nations. So this is given, right? Okay. So if I say Brazil, okay, China, France, Germany, Japan, India, Russia, UK, US. Okay, here GDP is given, already given, GDP is given, that is 2, 10, 3. Four, five, two, two, 317. Okay, GDP is given, but so which nation is that A, B, C, D in the previous graph, this graph? So we need to identify which one is A, B, C, D based on information given. Now given is China has the highest agriculture sector GDP. So China would highest. Okay. So there are three things: agriculture, service and industry. Okay. These three things are there. So China has highest. Okay. Here this will be the number one. Okay, valued at 1 trillion. Okay, this is given 1 trillion. So that means China agriculture sector should be 10% of the GDP. Right? So can I identify that? Agriculture is green, 10% of GDP is this. So F is China. Right? F is 100% China. So that means I can... Okay, now say service would be 48% and industry would be 42%. Service 48 and industry 42. So service 48, that means 4.8 and this is 4.2. So this is also identified because I know that China is F. Okay. And followed respectively by USA and India. So agriculture second would be USA, third would be India. Right? Can we identify that? Because the total is different. So I think this would be a bit difficult. Right? Just see that because the total is different. So we need to either calculate everything, but that will be PNC permutation combination. So let's skip this step for now. Okay, in terms of percentage contribution to the respective nations' GDPs by their service sectors, the UK and France are respectively the first and second. So UK and France are first and second, but percentage contribution to the respective nations' GDP. Right? So first would be UK, second would be France. In service sector, first UK, so UK, so where is this service sector is blue one, so the topmost is this, so this must be UK and second is France, so D and H, okay, D and H identified, right, so this F was China, this is UK, D is UK and H is France. Okay. So UK and France also identified. So D, F, H gone. Okay. So UK is D and France is H. Okay. So we can write the values also. If possible, right, let's see, UK the total is 3, UK the total is 3, so 1% 7920, 17920, okay, so 1% 79%, okay, so that is actually not needed. Right, and 2%, 1%, no, 20%, okay, 20% would be 0.6, right, similarly, you can write it for that also, okay, leave that. Third is nation A, B and G have the same GDP, okay, A, B and G have the same GDP, now same GDP is 2 and 2. So Brazil, India, Russia. So Brazil, India, Russia are A, B, and G. Okay, out of A, B, and G. Brazil, India, Russia. Okay, this is also out of A, B, and G. And out of A, B, and G. Right? The GDP of India's industry sector is lower than the GDP of Russia's industry sector. However, it is larger than that of Brazil's industry sector. So this is clear now, because the total is same. So you can just see industries. India must be lower than Russia, and however, it is larger than Brazil. So Brazil, India, Russia in industry, in industry sector, that is the topmost. So A, B, and G. A, B, and G. So India would be A, right? And it is more than Brazil. So Brazil will be G, and Russia will be B. Okay? Because this is the order, right? India A, Russia B. Okay. India A, Russia B. So India would be A, Russia would be B. So this would be G. Right? A, B, and G. So you can identify that. Okay. Now, which is remaining? So this, Germany, Japan, and USA, these are remaining. Right? Can you identify that? Followed by, it is saying USA and India in this, right? In case of agriculture, okay, let's say USA and India, what is the agriculture? Okay. USA and India. India is fixed. Okay, India is fixed. Just see. India is fixed. It is 17%, right? 17%. Okay, let's see. 17% of 2 is, this would be 10% would be 0.2. So, 17% would be 0.34. Right? So definitely China is 1, so US, India is 2, so 0.34, it US should be second place, that means it should be more than 0.34. Okay, let's check the three remaining, right? Remaining are, okay, let's see, A gone, B gone, D gone, F gone, G gone, H gone. So remaining are C, E, and I, right? C, E, and I. In this, the total GDP is 17 for US. 17, 3%, 3% of 17 would be 0.51, right? In case of C. In case of E, 5%, so it would be 17, 5%, so 0.85. Right, and in case of 1, I, so it would be 17.1%, that is 0.17. Okay, just see India's GDP, because it should be at the second place. It should be at the second place, right, in agriculture. So that means India's, it is 0.34, right? India's, it is 0.34. So that means, this is not possible. So I is not US, right? I is not US, right? But C and E, US may be there, right? C and E, US may be there. So let's see, US can be C or E, right? And depending upon what US is, these Germany and Japan can be anything. So that means correctly we can identify only 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. US, there is a possibility of C or E. Right? Now check the questions. Based on the given info, how many nations can you uniquely identify? 6. Right? We can identify 6 nations. Right? This is one of the question. Then, based on the given information, which of the following cannot be ruled out? Now, this is cannot be ruled out, right? Okay, just see, this is a statement which is logical. So, cannot be ruled out. It is not which can be ruled out, but cannot be ruled out. Right? Now, India is nation B is wrong. It is wrong. Right? Russia is nation G. This is also wrong. Right? Which cannot be ruled out means which should be true. Japan is nation E. Okay. Possibility. So, it cannot be ruled out. Right? This is a possibility. So, it cannot be ruled out. Right? US is nation I. This is wrong because I told you US can be only C or E. Right? China is nation C. Wrong. So, this is the possibility. So, this cannot be ruled out. Right? So, this was the possibility which cannot be ruled out. Japan can be nation E. Right? Because the possibility for Japan is C, E or I. Based on what US is. Right? And what Germany is. US, Germany or Japan. So, the three possibilities. Right? But US only C and E. One of Japan and Germany, it one of that will be I. Okay. So, let's move to next one. Which of the following information when considered in addition to the given information does not allow us to completely identify the nine nations in the graph? So, does not allow. Right. That means even if you know this information, you cannot find the nine nations. Okay. Now, Germany's industry GDP is US dollar 1.2 trillion. Okay, just see. Just see this in the data. Oh. Germany's industry is 1.2 trillion. Okay, the possibilities are C, E and I. Okay. One thing that we know, Germany's total GDP is 4, right? So, 4, now 4, C, it is industry is this, 4, 25%, that would be 1. So, that is not, so this is not the case, E, 4, 20%, this is not the core, I, 4, 30%. That means, right, with this statement, right, with this statement, you will get to know that Germany is I. Okay? So, that means, with this statement, you will get to know that Germany is I. If Germany is I, right, now, there is still pending between Japan and US, because US can be C or E. So, Japan can also be C or E. So, there is still a confusion. So, even if this information is there, you cannot completely identify the nine nations. So, this should be your answer. Okay, let's see. Next one. Both Japan's and Germany's industry GDPs are more than US dollar 1 trillion. If both Japan and Germany's industry GDP are more than US dollar 1 trillion, okay, let's see the data. Japan and Germany, both industry GDP more than one. Right? Germany the total is 4, Japan the total is 5. Okay? Now, see, Germany the total is 4. Right? 4 industry 25%. This cannot be possible because it should be more than 1 trillion. Right? So, for this, it should be the case. So, Germany should be this. Right? And for 5, so then it should be the case because then 20% is not possible. So, this must be Japan. So, US must be E. Right? So, you can identify all. Right, with this information, you can identify all, uniquely identify. right? Because Germany can be this only, because it should be more than 1 trillion, right? 4, 30% would be more than 1. Then for 5, more than 1, it can be only 25%. It cannot be 20%, that will be 1, right? So here you can easily identify all these three, right? So this is sufficient. So this cannot be an answer because it should does not allow the completely identify. So you can here you can identify, right? So this cannot be your answer. Japan's industry GDP is $1.25 trillion, right? If Japan's industry GDP, again Japan total was 5, and it should be 25%, right? That case of 25%. Okay, just see. So Japan must be this 25% out of CEI. Now if C gone, that means E must be US. So E must be US because US cannot be I. So E must be US, right? US cannot be I. So that means you can still identify all three, right? So here also you can identify. So this cannot be your answer. The nation ranked fourth in terms of agriculture GDP. Its agriculture GDP valued at $150 billion. So fourth in term of agriculture, right? This cannot be US, right? And if it is, okay, you can solve this, but with this, so answer is first, right? Clearly, because with Germany's industry GDP, you can find Germany, but US and Japan you cannot find. That is clear. So your answer must be this. Okay, let's move to next one. You can identify these also. Okay, next is this question. In the figure given below, the circle has a chord. Okay, AB is a chord of length 12 centimeter, which makes an angle of 60 degree at the center. Okay, this is 60 degree. At the center of the circle O, ABCD as shown in the diagram is a rectangle. So this is a rectangle. OQ is the perpendicular bisector of AB. OQ is the perpendicular bisector of AB. Okay. Intersecting the chord AB at P. So here it would be P. The arc AB at M. Arc AB at M. And CD at Q. So here it is Q. OM equal to MQ. OM equal to MQ. So you know, if this AB is 12, if AB is 12, so and this is 60 degree, so this is an equilateral triangle, right? That means this is also 12, this is also 12, and this is, these are radii, OA, OB. OM is also radii. So OM will also be 12. So MQ will also be 12. So OQ will be 24. Right? OA is radius. OB is radius. OM is also radius. So if AB is 12 and this is equilateral, so OA will be 12. So this will also be 12. And MQ is equal to OM. So this will be also 12. The area of the region enclosed by the line segment AQ, and QB and the arc BMA. Okay, so this area, okay, so he's talking about this area, right, is closest to, so he's talking about this area and closest to he's talking about, right? Okay, so you can calculate, okay, you can calculate actual area also. Here it is an equilateral triangle of 12, dimension 12, right, which is root 3 by 4, 12 square, right? This is the area of OAB, and here area is AB and Q. So this is an equilateral this is a triangle where your base is 12 And height is, okay, height is, so the height is 12 plus this, right? Which is, now from here to here, this is altitude of equilateral triangle, right? Which will become 12 minus, right? This, I am talking about PM length. PM length I am talking about. So, this is 12 minus root 3 by 2 into 12, right? Which is altitude of equilateral triangle, OP. So, this is actually, I have written OM minus OP, right? So, this is equal to your PM. So, which is, you can write like this, 12 minus root 3, 6. Okay, I will take the values in decimal form, right, approximate form. So, this will be 1.7. 1.7 into 6 is 17, 6, 10.2. So, 12, if you subtract, this would be 1.8. Okay, so PM is 1.8 and from here to here, okay, the total is 24, okay, total is 24, so why should I calculate PM actually? For height, I only need this OP, okay, we only needed OP, so this was not needed, right? We only needed this 10.2. So, OP is 10.2, right? And OQ, the complete length is 24. So, 24 minus 10.2, right? This is OQ minus OP. So, this will be OQ minus OP will be PQ. That is the height of that triangle ABQ, right? So, this will become 13.8, right? So, here area is root 3, area of this triangle is root 3 by 4, 12 square and their area is half base height. So, half base height, it would be half, base is 12 and height is this 13.8, right? So, this is the area of complete A, this complete your quadrilateral A, O, B, Q, right? So, this becomes 4 into 36, 36 into 1.7, okay? So, 36 into 1.7, 17 into 6, 102, 17 into 3, 51, 61, right? Okay, plus 6 into 8, 48, 6 into 13, 78 and 4, 82. So, total area of this is 80 plus 60, 143, 144. Okay, total area, right? Out of this, because total quadrilateral minus this sector is the area required. So, sector area is 1/6, because 60 degree, 1/6 of the circle. So, 1/6 of the circle, 1/6 pi, okay, pi I will take 3.14. R square is 12 square, 144. 6 into 24. 24 into, okay, 24, 4, 96, 24, 1, 33, 24, 3, 72, 75. So, approximate 144 minus 75. So, that will be 69. Yes, 69 should be the correct answer. Right? You can take all these values approximate also. Right? I have shown you the method, complete method, but you can take the approximate values also. One other method, right? The other method may be, that directly you go for, okay, this area of this triangle, which we calculated this, right? 6 into 13, 82.8. Right? 82.8. Then, okay, but then this will be close. Between 69 and, because remaining you can reject. Right? Remaining you can reject. Because this is more than half. So, 82 more than half, 35 is not possible, but it is less than, the area required is less than 82, right? So, these are not possible. So, but 69 and 63 will be close, right? Then you need to select between those. Okay, let's move to next one. 190 students have to choose at least one elective and at most two electives from a list of three electives, E1, E2 and E3. Okay, this is kind of set theory. Okay, so E1, E2 and E3. He is saying that everybody, so union must be 190, because 190 they will select at least one. Right, that union must be 190. Okay, but at least one and at most two elective. So that means here it is zero. So they cannot select three. Right, at most two electives they can select. So they cannot select three. So this is zero. It is found that number of students choosing E1 is half the number of students choosing E2. Okay, E1. Who are selecting E1 is half of E2, one third of E3. Okay, one third of E3. That means the ratio is, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. This is half of 2, one third of 3. So that means x, 2x, 3x you can take. So E1 total is 1, 2 or 3. Moreover, the number of students choosing two electives is 50. Okay, just see that if they all select one subject, the total must be 190, right? Because the total students are 190, each selecting one, 190 into one, 190. But out of that, 50 students are selecting one extra subject. So total must be 190 plus 50, 240. So here 1x plus 2x plus 3x must be 240, which is 190 plus 50, that 50 extra. Because 50 students are selecting two subjects. So, total number of subjects will become 240. Right? So, this is 6x is 240. So, x is 60. No, x is 40. Right? So, here E1 should be 40. E2 should be 80. And E3 should be 120. Right? Now, the total seems 240. But there is overlapping between in 50. Right? So here total of sum of this plus this plus this is 50, right? So these three, okay, let's say A, B and C. So A plus B plus C is 50, right? Which of the following cannot be determined from the given information? Cannot be. Number of students choosing either E1 or E2 or both, but not E3. Just see, E1 or E2 or both, but not E3. That means this one, this area, okay, let's identify this area and this area, these three areas. E1 or E2 or both, but not E3. So, not this circle. But you know that this circle total is 120. So, this total must be 70 because the total is 190. This circle's total is 120. So, these three total is 70. So, you can calculate this. But it is which cannot be obtained. So, this cannot be your answer because this can be calculated. Right? Okay. Now, number of students choosing E1. Now, E1, 40 is there. I can calculate. So, this cannot be your answer. Number of students choosing both E1 and E2. both E1 and E2, this you cannot calculate because B is total is given. So this you cannot calculate. Third is your answer. Number of students choosing exactly one elective, you know, because this total is 50. This plus this plus this is 50. So this plus this plus this must be 140 because total is 190. Right, this can be calculated, so cannot be answered. Number of students choosing E3, yes, E3 total is 120. This is already known. So third option is your correct answer. Number of students choosing E1 and E2, this B cannot be calculated. Right, you know A plus B plus C, but you cannot calculate A or B or C. Right, okay, next one. Now the question was, in addition to the given information, which of the following information is necessary and sufficient to compute the number of students choosing only E1, only E2 and only E3? Okay, just see, only E1, only E2 and only E3. You need to calculate separately X, Y and Z, right? And it is saying that which of the following information is necessary and sufficient, okay, necessary and sufficient also, right, so that you don't require more information, and necessary also, that is minimum that information is required, okay. So no extra information is necessary, wrong, because it is necessary, because you cannot identify XYZ, right, that is the total is given. Number of students choosing only E1 and number of students choosing both E2 and E3, okay. If you are given only E1, that means this is given, and choosing both E2 and E3, okay, both E2 and E3, that means this is given. So X is given, C is given, right? But how can you answer now? Because Y and Z you cannot calculate because A and B can interchange. C you know, suppose C you know, then A plus B will be constant, but A and B here it may change, and depending upon A and B, Y and Z will change, right? So you cannot get the correct answer, right? So this is also not sufficient, okay. Now this is also not sufficient. Now, number of students choosing only E2 and number of students choosing both E2 and E3, okay. Only E2 and both E2 and E3. Only E2, this is given. Both E2 and E3, this is given. Okay, now this is interesting. This now you can calculate. Why? Because you know the total here. And if you know this and this, you can calculate this also. Because the sum must be 80. If these two are given, so this you can calculate. If this is given, now this is given and this is given, B and C you know, then you can calculate A. If A and B you know, you can calculate X. A and C you know, you can calculate Z. Right? So all X, Y, Z can be calculated with this information. Right? So this is correct. Right? This is correct. Necessary and sufficient. Number of students choosing both E1 and E2, right? See here, only both E2 and E3, with that this was given, that also was not sufficient. So only this is not sufficient at all. Number of students choosing both E1 and E2, number of students choosing both E2 and E3, number of students choosing both E3 and E1. That means A, B and C, all three are given. Here you can calculate. Here you can calculate. If A, B, C are given, you can calculate X, Y, Z. But was this necessary information? Okay, just see. If A and B are given, why should I require C? Because A plus B plus C I can calculate. So this was not necessary. Extra information is given. The key word was that it is asking for necessary and sufficient. Sufficient it is. It is sufficient, but it is not necessary. Extra information is given. Here it was necessary, that minimum this you can calculate. But here without this third information, if two of these are given, that is sufficient. So this was not necessary, right? So your answer must be third option. Next one. A box contains 6 cricket balls, 5 tennis balls and 4 rubber balls. Okay, cricket 6, tennis 5, rubber balls 4. Of these, some balls are defective. The proportion of defective cricket balls is more than the proportion of defective tennis balls, but less than the proportion of defective rubber balls. So, proportion, right? So, proportion of uses defective cricket balls. Cricket balls, the proportion of cricket balls, defective cricket balls, is more than the proportion of defective tennis balls, but less than rubber balls. So that means tennis ball defective proportion is the least, then cricket, then rubber balls. Okay. Moreover, the overall proportion of defective balls is twice the proportion of defective tennis balls. Okay. This is twice. So this is double of this. Right? Two times. Right? What best can be said about the number of defective rubber balls? Okay, rubber balls. Okay, it's talking about 2, 3, 4, something like that. Rubber balls. Okay, let's see. Let's see. Because my proportion of tennis balls is the least. And rubber balls, it is double. Right? Okay, defective tennis balls. Let's say, right, defective balls. What if it is 1? Because number of defective balls will be integers. Right? Let's say 1. So, defective tennis ball, if it is 1, so 1 by 5. 1 by 5, that is 20%. If 20%, right? Okay. Now, rubber ball is not twice. Okay, just see. Rubber ball is not twice. It is given overall proportion of defective balls. Overall proportion of defective ball is twice. That means if 20% here, defective tennis balls are there. So, that means overall it must be 40%. So, total number of balls, so total balls proportion is double of proportion of tennis ball. If this is 1 by 5, that means 20%. So, 40% overall balls must be defective. So, overall total number of balls are 4, 5, 9 and 6, 15. So, if it is 20%, so 40%, that means 40% means 6. So, 6 balls must be defective, right? And proportion, it is 20%, right? So, rubber balls must be greater than cricket ball, must be greater than this. Okay, let's see. Now, cricket ball, it is greater than 20%, right? Let's say 1. 1 by 6, it is not possible. 2 by 6, 33%, yet it is possible, right? So, if it is 2, then this is greater than this. Proportion is greater than, because it was 20%, this is 33.33%. Now, the remaining is 3. 3 by 4 is 75%, yes, this is greater. So, rubber ball proportion is greater, so this satisfied. Now, if it is 1, it can be 3 also. But if it is 3, this becomes 50%. Now, the total number of defective balls are 6. So, 1 and 3, 4. So, this must be 2. So, this 2 by 4 is again 50%. So, this is also 50%. This is also 50%. So, this is not possible. Right? Because rubber balls proportion must be greater than proportion of cricket balls. Defective. Right? Okay. So, for 1, this is the only possibility. Right? If tennis ball is 1, rubber ball must be 3. Okay. Now, if tennis ball is 2, that means 2 by 5 is 40%. So, overall defective must be 80%. because that is double. So 80% of 15 is 12. If this is 2, right, and total number of defective balls are 12, so remaining 10 more must be defective. So here 6 and 4, so all must be defective. But then this will be 100%, this will be 100%, this cannot be equal. So this case is gone. So only this case is the feasible case, right? Only this one possibility is there, which is that red balls, rubber balls must be 3, tennis ball must be 1, cricket ball must be 2, overall must be 6 defective, right? So the number of defective rubber balls must be 3, exactly 3. There is no other possibility that exists, right? Okay. Let's move to next one. 6 drums are used to store water. 5 drums are of equal capacity, while the 6th drum has double the capacity of each of these 5 drums. Okay. So you can say that 5 drums, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 drum. So they are having 1 capacity, this having 2 capacity, right? Now, 1 morning, 3 drums are found to be half full, 2 are found 2/3, and 1 is found completely full, okay? So, now there are 3 possibility that this 2, this capacity 2, this bigger container, right, bigger drum, that may be half full, because 3 drums are half full, right, that this may be half full and these 2 may be half full and 2 are found 2/3, so 2/3 and 1 is completely full. Or this, the different term, this may be 2/3 full. So, 2/3, 2 of 2/3 is 4/3. So, 2/3, 1 more. This may be 2/3, right? Any one of these. And half these 3, 3 are half and 1 is completely full. The third case, that this may be completely full and this may be half and 2/3. So these are the possibilities. So it is attempted to transfer all the waters to the smaller drums. How many smaller drums are adequate to store the water? Right? So all water is to be stored in the smaller drum. Okay, let's say the total of the water in any case. So this is half plus half, 1, 1, 2, 3, and 2/3 plus 2/3. So 4/3. That is 1/3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1/3. So the total is 4/3. So how many drums will be required? 5. Because in 4 drums you cannot fill this, because 4 plus 1/3. So 5th drum is also required. So the number of drums required are 5. Here half plus half, 1, 2, 4/3, 2/3, 6/3 means 2. So 2 plus 2, 4, 4.5. So total is 4.5. So again 5 drums are required, right? Because 4.5, 4 drums cannot suffice, though they will not suffice. So 5th drum is required. Okay. So here half plus half, 1, 2/3, 2/3, 4/3. 4/3 is 1/3. So 1 is here, 2 is here. So already 4/1/3 plus half, that is more than 4, less than 5, again 5 drums are required. So in any case 5 drums are required. Okay, first is not true, second is not true, third is not true, 5 but not 4. Yes, that is correct. 5 may be inadequate, no. So fourth option, 5 but not 4. So 5 are required, not 4. Okay. Let's move to next one. Now, during 2015-19, the revenue of companies P, Q, R, S were as follows. Okay? So, revenue is given. Which of the given company has seen the highest year-on-year growth in percentage in any single year? Okay? So, this is simple. Highest growth. Okay? This is year-on-year. This is 25-150, that means 1 by 6. Okay, 1 by 6. Here 25-170, this is 1 by 7. So 1 by 6 is more. This is 1 by 5. So 1 by 5 is more. Now 1 by 4. 50 on 200. 1 by 4. So this is 25%. 1 by 4. So 1 by 4. Anything more than 1 by 4? Okay, this is not. This is 40 by 140. Right, so 2 by 7, 2 by 7 is 28 point some percent, right? So this is more than this. So this is more. 2 by 7, 30 on 180. No, this is less. This is less. This is very less. Less, less. 3 on 14. No, less. So this is maximum. So Q must be your answer, right? This growth is maximum. Right, this growth is maximum 40 on 140, which is 2 by 7. 2 by 7 is the maximum, right, which is 28.56%. Okay. Next one, it was discovered later that one of the companies misreported its revenue of one of the years. If the misreported revenue is replaced by the correct revenue, the revenues of the company over the 5-year period will be in an AP. Okay, so one value need to be rectified and the all terms will become in an AP. Okay, let's see. So one value is 150, 175, 200. Okay, if this is 225, instead of this, if it is 225, this will become AP. Instead of this, if you take 225, this will become AP. So this is possible. 15, 20, 30. So, no, this is not possible. 50 plus 10 plus 20 plus 20 plus 40. So, here also discrepancy is also. This is not possible. 20, 20. Okay. If this is 160, so this will become AP. Right? If you correct this one or this one, so these will become AP. Right? Okay. Let's see the question. So, the company that misreported its revenues are P or S? Yes, this is your answer. Right? Both are possible. P or S, both are possible. Right? Misreported the revenue. Maybe this is misreported or this is misreported. So, this will become, if you correct this will become AP. So, there are two possibilities. Right? So, P or S would be your correct answer. Okay, next one. So, this question was easy actually. During the period 2014-15, the revenue increased by 25% for three of the companies and by 50% of the remaining company. The total increase in the revenue for all the four companies put together was rupees 125 lakh. Which of the following cannot be true? Okay. So, we need to see the data simultaneously. 25% for three companies. Total increase it is given. Okay, let's see. Okay. Let's see. Here, three companies increased by 25% and one by 2015 it is saying. So, 2014-15, right? Three companies increased by 25% and one by 50%. Let's say if this is why 50%, so this means there must be increase from 100 to 150. So the increase for P would be 50. Here it would be 25. Here it would be, because it is 25%, so 4 is to 5. So 120 to 150, that means increase of 30. This is 4 is to 5, so increase of 20. So, if this is 50%, if P is 50%, So the total will be 50 and 50, 100, 125. This is possible, right? He was saying that total is 125, right? Okay, if Q is 50%, it is not possible that integer won't be there, right? If R is 50%, the value will be same because this will interchange. So this will also be correct. If S is 50%, then this is not a multiple of 3. So again, it will be in decimal. So only two possibility, P or R must be 50% and rest all must be 25%. Okay, let's see now question. The question is, from 2014, the revenue of P and R increased by different amounts. Yes, by different amounts, because one of them must be 50% and one of that must be 25%, and both total is 150. So they will change with different amounts. So this is true, but the question is cannot be true. So this is true, right? This is true. So this cannot be my answer. The company that experienced the 50% increase in revenue also experienced the maximum increase in revenue in absolute terms. This is also true because there the increase was of 50 rupees, 50 whatever, 50 something, 50 lakhs, right? But otherwise, all other companies have less growth, right? This is also true. So cannot be my answer. So this is also correct, right? The 2014 revenues of P and R cannot be determined uniquely. This is also true because P and R, they can be interchanged. So cannot be determined uniquely. So they can be interchanged. So this cannot be my answer. From 2014 to 15, the increase in the revenue of at least two companies were the same. At least two companies were the same. Okay, let's see. There were 125, I think. Okay, 125. Okay, just see the increase. Okay, it cannot be the same. So this is wrong. The increase will be like this only. So increase cannot be the same, right? So this is my answer. Two companies, the increase cannot be same. So they all are different. The revenue of Q in 2014 was the same as the revenue of R in 2014. Q and R, the revenue of Q and R, so that will be same, right? Why? Because Q and R both will be 100 in 2014, right? Just see this. Q and R both will be 100, so this may be same, right? He's saying cannot be true. So this can be true, right? This can be true because this is 25 growth and this is 50 growth. So Q and R may be 2014, 100 may be possibility. So he's saying which cannot be true, right? Which cannot be true. So this may be true, right? So this is the answer. Fourth is definitely wrong. That is cannot be true. So fourth is your answer. Okay, let's move to next one. Mohanlal, a prosperous farmer, has a square land of site 2 km for the current season. He decided to have some fun. Okay, so square land of 2 km. He decided to have some fun. He marks two distinct points on one of the diagonals of the land. Okay, so one of the diagonal of the land, two points. Using these points as center, he constructs two circles. Each of these circles falls completely within the land and touches at least two sides of the land. To his surprise, the radii of both the circles are exactly equal to 2 by 3 kilometer. Okay, just see. Now, this circle, so the center is here. Again, here also there is a circle. And the center is here, right? It is touching 2 points. Okay, he is saying that this is 2/3. So this must be the radii. So this is 2/3. This is radii, 2/3. So this is also 2/3. Right? Mohanlal plants potatoes on the overlapping portion of these circles. So here he is planting the potatoes. Calculate the area on which Mohanlal planted potatoes in square. So you need to find this area. Okay, just see. Okay, if I know that this is 2/3, this is also 2/3. Okay, let's join this. Let's divide this entire square, in 9 parts. Right? Thus, each square will be 2/3 into 2/3, 2/3, 2 by 3. Because 2 dimension by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3. So, the circles are now like this, that it will, one is this center, one is this center. And this will also touch like this. So, this circle will be like this. So, it will touch like this. This circle also touch like this. So, that means this overlapping area is actually here. Right? Okay. Okay, area of this center square. What is the area of the center square? Right? Because the total area is 4 divided in 9 equal areas. So, the square area of this is 4 by 9. So, my overlapping area, right, must be definitely less than 4 by 9. Okay, definitely less than 4 by 9. First, calculate these answers. So, approximate answers. Okay, just see. This is 3.1 in plus 4. So, 7.1. 7.1 into 5. Right? It is actually 7.14 into 5. So, 14 into 5 is 70. So, 35.7. 35.7 divided by 27. Right. Okay, if I talk about, this is more than 1. This is more than 1. And this area should be, overlapping area should be less than 4 by 9. So, this is not possible. Right. Here, numerator is more than denominator. So, numerator is less than the denominator. Rather, it should be close to 2 by 9. Okay, let's see. Here, it is 2 into 3. So, let's say 6. Right, 6.2 or 6.3 minus 3 into 1.7, it is 3 into 1.7 is 5.1. So, 6.3 minus, let's say 6.3 minus 5.1, it would be 1.2 into 2.4. 2.4 divided by 27, this is very, very low. So, not possible. Right, 2.4 only divided by 27. So, very, very low. Right, so just reject that. Now, pi minus 2, 3.14 minus 2. So, 1.14 by 9. Okay, it is less than 2 by 9. Okay, let's see this. Okay, here. Because what area we are talking about is a square of 4 by 9. And in that, the overlapping will be something like this. Right? When you actually do, the overlapping of the circles will be like this. So, this is close to half. So, it will be 2 by 9. Okay? Let's see. 3.14 minus 2. So, it would be 1.14 into 2. So, 2.2 by 9. So, this is very close. This is more than half. Right? So, 4 by 9, 2 by 9. So, this is close. So, this is not possible because this is less than half, very half. So, this is also cancel. So, this is possible. Now, 4 pi, which is 4 into 3, 12. Minus 5, so 7 into 2, 14, 14 by 27, right? Okay, just see this, just this close, 4 into 3.1, so it will be 3.14 into 4, 4, 3, 12, 12.56, minus 3 into 1.7, 5.1,
So this will be 7.46 into 2. So it will become 14.8 divided by 27. So this is more than half, right? This is definitely less than half. So this is 2 by 9, close to 2 by 9. It is not this. So this is not true. So only possibility is this. Right? Only possibility is this. Okay, let's move to next one. What is the remainder if 19 raised to power 20 minus 20 raised to power 19 is divided by 7? Okay, we know how to divide this. Right, 19 raised to power 20 minus 20 raised to power 19 divided by 7. So this is 7 into 2, 14. So this will give me remainder as 5 raised to power 20. Right, minus 27. So minus 1 raised to power 19. Okay, so let's solve this first. 5 raised to power 20 is giving me remainders. Okay, 5 raised to power 1 will give me remainder 5. 5 raised to power 2 divided by 7. 25 divided by 7 remainder would be 4. 5 raised to power 3. Now 4 into 5, 20. This will give me remainder minus 1. Right? This will give me remainder minus 1. So I can do. Or 5 raised to power 6 will give me remainder plus 1. So this is 5 raised to power 6 raised to power 3 into 5 raised to power 2. This is minus 1. So 5 raised to power 6 will give me remainder 1. 25 by 7. 25 by 7 give me remainder 4 and plus 1. So 4 plus 1, 5 would be my answer.
Right, if you know how to get the remainders, this is very, very easy. Right, rather I am just showing you how to do this, otherwise it is very easy. Okay, so let's move to next one. A rectangular field is 40 meter long and 30 meter wide. 40, 30. Draw a diagonal to this field and then draw circles of radius. Okay, diagonals. Circles of radius 1.25 meters with the center only on the diagonals. Okay, so 1.25 meter. So, like this. So, the diameter would be 2.5. With centers only on diagonals, each circle must fall completely within the field. Any two circles can touch each other but should not overlap. What is the maximum number of such circles that can be drawn to the field? Okay, just see. First see that the length of the diagonal is going to be 50 because 30, 40. So, this is going to be 50, right? From here to here. Okay? Now, there will be this gap here because 1.25 here, 1.25 here. So, this from this center, okay, just see the corner. If there is one circle here, right, one diagonal is coming from here, center. So, if this is 1.25, this is also 1.25. So, from here to here, this distance is 1.25 root 2. Right, approximately this. So if I 125 into 14, if I do, so 125 into 4, 500, 125 into 1, 125, 175. So something like 1.75. So 1.25 till here, so approximately 0.5 will be here. So this margin will be 0.5, this margin will be 0.5 here. Right, this corner also margin will be 0.5, this portion where the circle won't touch, all other circle will touch each other. Okay, I will take like this, right, and dia of one circle is 2.5, 1.25 meter is radius, so 2.5 is dia, right, and the length
on the diameter is only, dekho, 0.5 wasted, so 49 meter, right? 49 meters divided by 2.5. So I can have a maximum of 19 circles here. So 19 circle on this diagonal, right? I will take one circle at the center, 9 here, 9 here. So on this diagonal also one circle is common. So 9 here, 9 here. So 9, 9, 9, 9, 36 plus 1 at the center. So 37. So 37 circles you can have. Right? 37 circles you can have. Okay? So let's move to next one. A shop sells bags in three sizes, small, medium and large. A large bag costs rupees 1000, medium 200 and small bag costs rupees 50. Three buyers A, B and C independently buy some number of these types of bags. The respective amount spent by A, B and C are equal. Okay. Put together, the shop sells one large bag, 15 small bags and some medium bags. Okay, what is the minimum number of medium bags? Okay, one large bag means 1 into 1000. So total is 1000. 15 small bags means 15 into 50. So total is 15 into 50, 750. Right? Now you are having this also, right? This is into 200. Right? He is saying minimum number of small bags. I will go by the choices. Right? Let's say it is 4. Minimum is 4. 200 into 4 is 800. So 1000 plus 750 plus 800. This will be 2550. But whoever buys large bag will spend minimum of 1000 and they are spending equally, right? The respective amount spent by them are equal. So one person minimum will spend 1000, right? Because whoever purchased that large bag will minimum spend 1000. So the total must be minimum 3000 because 1000 each minimum, right? So, minimum 3000 should be the total. So, this is not possible. If 5 into 200, 1000, 1,2750. So, this is not possible. Let's talk about 7. If 7 is there, this is 1400. This is 1000. So, 2400 plus 7, 3150 divide by 3. They can spend 1050 each. Yes, they can. So 7 is your answer, right? Yes, they can spend 1050. One person will buy one large plus one small, so he will spend 1050. One person will buy, we are spending 7 here, so that means 5 medium and one small. This is possible. Now the remaining 2 medium and how many small remaining? 15 small, so 2 gone, 13 small. 13 into 5, 650 plus 400, 1050. So this is possible. So minimum 7 is possible. Right? You can directly say that the logic was that minimum they need to spend 3000. So 3000 plus you need to consider that 4 and 5 are not possible. Now, a hair and a tortoise run between point O and P located exactly 6 km from each other on a straight line. They start together at O, go straight to P and then return to O along the same line. They run at speeds of 12 km per hour and 1 km per hour respectively. Since the tortoise is slower than the hare shuttles between O and P until the tortoise goes once to P and returns back to O.
During the run, how many times are the hair and the tortoise separated by an exact distance of 1 kilometer from each other? Okay. So here, what is happening? They started from this point. Okay, starting point. And this is the opposite point, 6 kilometer. Okay. So 6 kilometer distance and O and P. Okay. So this is O, this is P. Right. So, what will happen if tortoise is completing one circle of 6 kilometer plus 6 kilometer, that is 12 kilometer, because the speed ratio is 12:1, if tortoise will run one round like this, in the same time, the hare will run 12 rounds, right? 12 rounds. So, let's say this is the round of hare. So, first round, so he will like this, he will do second round, right, and so on up to 12 rounds, right. So, going, coming back. Ideally, while going, he should create 1 kilometer distance twice. One, where tortoise should be 1 kilometer behind him, one where tortoise is 1 kilometer ahead of him, right? Ideally, I am taking ideal scenario. So, some tortoise is going somewhere, hare is coming. So, tortoise is 1 kilometer ahead of him, so gap of 1 kilometer, and then he crossed tortoise, he will become 1 kilometer ahead of tortoise. So, ideally, two such cases. In one side. So, two cases here. So, 4 on each round. So, 4 into 12, 48 should be the ideal cases. Right? I will subtract some cases. So, 48 should be the cases normally for each case. Going 2 should be there, coming back 2 should be there, going 2 should be there, coming back 2 should be there. Okay? Now, let's see. While starting, you cannot have tortoise. Here cannot have tortoise 1 kilometer ahead of him. So, one case gone. So, here going, one case gone. Right? He will become 1 kilometer ahead, but he cannot be 1 kilometer behind. The hare cannot be 1 kilometer behind. So, one case gone. While coming back, he was 1 kilometer from here at a distance, but when he crossed 1 kilometer, he make the distance, because now when he reached here, here will be 1 kilometer, because he has completed 12 kilometer, here will be 1. So here, if you count this point that here reaches here and tortoise will be 1 kilometer exact difference, so it is plus 2. So no need to do that minus thing right here. But then this point is common here also. When it started, right, it started moving. So, gap of 1 kilometer, right, this gap of 1 kilometer, or because it started, the tortoise is also already here. So, it is already 1 kilometer, which is taken here, which you have considered in this round. You cannot consider this now again. So, again, I will do minus 1 here. Right? The same case, because hare reaches this point and tortoise is 1 kilometer ahead. So, you can consider that 1 kilometer ahead, or you can consider for the next round it is 1 kilometer behind. Right? So, 1 in the same thing. So, minus 1, minus 1. So, in 2 round it is minus 1. Right? Coming back, he will get that 2 round. So, minus 1, minus 1, it will be. Now, see that position when, let's say, 6th round, okay, 5th round, it won't be possible, 6th round, right, 6th round, that means, start of 6th round, the hare is, okay, tortoise is already at 5 kilometer at this position. Right, before this 5 round already happened. So
here tortoise has covered 5 kilometer and here has covered 5 into 12, that is 60 kilometers. So 5 round of 12 kilometers, right? Now in 6th round when here will start, it will be 1 kilometer behind, but till that time tortoise will cover certain distance ahead and there will not be a gap of 1 kilometer here. Here it will become less than 1 kilometer. And while coming back also, this will be less than 1 kilometer because tortoise will be certain ahead of that. So, one from here and one from here will be gone. So, in 6th round, there will be minus 2. Right? Going and coming, in both the cases, it will be minus 1, minus 1. So, one case won't be possible. 7th round is one in the same thing. 7th round also, because now the tortoise is at that position, end position. Right? So, going back, going, it will be gap of 1 kilometer here. Coming also 1 kilometer here. But in the that direction, it is not possible. So, again minus 2. So, for 6th and 7th round, it would be minus 2 and minus 2. Right? Now, this same thing will happen at the 11th and 12th round, that minus 1 and minus 1. Right? Because for 11th round, right? For 11th round, okay, just think of 11th round. Let's say this is 11th round. The tortoise is already at this 11 kilometer he has covered. This tortoise has covered 11 kilometer. Okay, or 11th round, before that it has covered 10 kilometer. Right, before that it has covered 10 kilometer. But for 11th round, when it will finish, 11th round, when it is finishing, so tortoise will be at 11 kilometer and it will be here will be at the starting position. So, gap of 1 kilometer will be that last position, right, which will be common to the next one. That means you will calculate minus 1 there if you calculate next position, right. So, next 1 kilometer if you consider, so 11th round you will take minus 1. And 12th round again when the tortoise is here, it will reach together, right. So, there cannot be 1 kilometer gap ahead, so again minus 1. So, these 2 to 4, 4 to 6 and 2 8 points you need to subtract and the total will be 40. So, 40 gaps of 1 kilometer can be created, right. Okay, so very interesting questions were there. So there were few very interesting questions. So good questions, good logical questions, right, in ZAT 2020. So it was a very good exam. Okay, so that's it. This was your quant section. Okay, so go through it. Thank you. That's it for this session. Okay. So, ZAT 2020 quant section. Thank you. See you in the next session. Thank you.